what's up, guys? Welcome to Wrong Angling. My name's Alex. Hit that subscribe button, help me grow my channel. I'm gonna start doing tip videos along with my fishing vlogs. Keep y'all updated on what I'm doing, and hopefully it helps some of y'all out. This tip, I'm letting y'all in on one of my secrets. If you've been watching the videos lately, I've been burning these bass up on a wacky rig with a spinning reel. The reason for that is because right now is pretty good time for finesse tactics, and the future is too. So when I say finesse tactics, I'm talking about wacky rigs, weightless Senkos, weightless flukes, and Ned rigs. Ned rigs are especially gonna be producing you some bites here shortly through the summer. So one thing about right now is fish are really shallow in the spring. And that's awesome because you know where they are, but it also makes them a little bit more finicky because they could see you before you see them. Two things you need to do to be able to catch fish in this situation. One, you need to be able to cast a pretty good distance away so that they don't see you. And also, you need to be having a fluorocarbon leader attached to your finesse bait or whatever you're throwing. If you're throwing a bait caster, throwing straight fluorocarbon is fine. Bait casters cast fluorocarbon really good. I can't say the same about spinning reels, but with braid, I can launch a bait with braid on a spinning reel. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna combine the best of those two both worlds. That way I can achieve both those things I just talked about, the distance and the fluorocarbon leader. So I have right now on this spinning reel 10 pound braid, and I'm gonna attach, I've even used a 14 fluorocarbon leader, but I'm gonna do a 8 pound test because I'm going to a really, really clear water lake here tomorrow. So one thing I can tell you to do, and you might get some, to me it's whatever works for you. This works for me. And I mean, you can tell me in the comment section it doesn't, but it does. I've been doing it. I know what I'm talking about. I've been using it, and it's been producing. So it's all about, if you want to go with heavier braid and heavier fluorocarbon, go ahead. If you want to go with a lighter setup like I do, or you don't think that, you know, if you want to go with a heavier braid and lighter fluorocarbon, that's fine too. You can do both. Like I said, what's been working for me recently is 10 pound braid with 14 pound fluorocarbon, but I have used 8 pound and it works good too. So I'm gonna go with the 8 pound today. So here's how you get the right amount. And it's just universal tactic, anybody can do it. Grab this, stretch your arm out, hold the end, stretch your arm out once, like this, as far as you can, reach up, grab it. And do it again. And you will need a pair of scissors. I do not advise you to bite off the line. You will chip your tooth. I've learned that the hard way. All right, so grab your fluorocarbon and just kind of feel it out. Make you a little bunny ear like that. And it crimps the line. It makes it easier to deal with. This is the Alberto knot. It's a simple tactic. I could tie it in a kayak on the water if I needed to. So with the bunny ear, take the braid, put it in like that, and just remember the way you put it in because it is important at the end. And I'll explain when it gets there. So take your ring finger and hold that braid like that, and then come around. Yeah, take your ring and thumb, better like that. All right, and then now come around and wrap it around both pieces of fluorocarbon. I'm gonna do this 10 times. You wanna kinda keep it straight as you can. Doesn't have to be perfect, but it does help. So I think that's 3, 4, 5. Six, seven, eight,
nine, 10. All right, there's your 10 times. All right, just kind of hold it there. Come back, do the same thing back to your right hand. All right, because if you're right-handed or if you're doing it left-handed, you know, back to your left hand. But one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, so remember, I put this in, I'm gonna take it, now I'm gonna put it out. And it's important because if you put it the same way and you pull that knot, it's gonna come through. But if you did it the right way, in the first time, out the last time, it's gonna be perfect. So grab the two pieces right here and then come over and grab your other two tag ends of fluorocarbon. And then just pull like this right here, pull both pieces. All right, and if you can grab both these pieces and pull and it not come undone, you did it right. And this is what it's gonna look like. All right, now get your scissors and trim up this knot. It's a nice slim knot. It'll go through the eyes of your fishing rod really easy. So go on, slim that up real nice with the scissors, and then I'm gonna get the tag in with this fluorocarbon right here. All right, there you go. So now you've got the best way to cast light baits, spinning reel. You got the best way using distance with braid. So you're gonna get the most distance out of the braid on spinning reel, I mean. But you're also gonna be able to get those finicky bass to bite with the fluorocarbon leader. They won't know the bait is a bait. They'll think it's just a little crawl or a little worm, whatever you're trying to imitate, and they should bite. All right, so that is my secret, my tip, my trick, what has been working really successfully for me. Like I said, it's all about preference and what works for you. If you like to use heavier pound test, that's cool. Just make sure that your drag is loose if you're using lighter pound test like I am, because this is 8 pound test, and Lord willing, I'll hook a 10 pound bass someday, and if I have confidence that I'll still be able to bring it in on this 10 pound braid and 8 pound fluorocarbon because of my loose drag. Yep. All right. Wrong angling, like, comment, subscribe, get out, get you some. Let me know in the comment section if it helps you. All right, peace. See y'all next time.